Mr. Ravishankar Prasad, leader of deputy leader of the opposition and BJP spokesperson as well, and JPC member, of course, Gurudas Dasgupta as well, Mr. Dasgupta and Ravishankar Prasad. I'm sorry, at this point of time, it does not appear, as it is clear from that interaction, that Mr. Chacko is willing to go in for a debate. But why do you call it a Congress report, Mr. Ravishankar Prasad, first?
First of all, I wish to make it very clear on a question of gross impropriety and breach of parliamentary procedures well settled. Or not till yesterday night till 12 o'clock I kept on waiting for this report, draft report. A message came, it will be sent to us. It did not come. I cross-checked with large number of members of the JPC. All of them said very firmly, we have not received it. It was all over everywhere on television and news and also in the morning newspapers.
Yes.
In the morning after 9:30 I get a copy of the report. I asked others, have you got a copy of the report? Some got around the same time, others haven't got. Now this is a very serious violation of well-settled parliamentary procedure that the media is in the know. Obviously it is the chairman's office of the JPC. None of the members have got a copy of the report, but it is all over. Now let me ask a question, Arnav, that is very important.
Yes.
Who would benefit by the sudden leak of this draft report?
So what are you suggesting?
We have a lot to say, please listen to me. Mr. Chacko is right there that we have to debate this issue. And I also don't want to go on the merits of the matter. We have a lot to say, which will say firmly and forcefully in the media of the JPC. But let me ask a question to myself. How is it that suddenly if we find that the entire media is full of report that the Prime Minister and the Finance Minister have been given a clean chit about a scam which has shamed the country world over? Biggest scam?
No, are you saying Mr. Chacko leaked the report? Are you saying Mr. Chacko has leaked the report?
I did not say that. I am only trying to point out the highly suspicious circumstances surrounding the leak.
Sir, Mr. Prasad, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to be a little bit more direct with me today. No, Mr. Prasad, the fact is, very serious charge, very serious. I first want to get the left party in. Mr. Gurudas Dasgupta, do you endorse that point of view of the BJP about the leakage of the report? Do you feel the leak of the report is motivated?
Let us speak our point of view without referring to other view expressed by other honourable members. I am not here for a debate or for a reply. If you would like, I will put up my points very clearly. Number one, I will tell you, the leakage of the report, whoever might have done it, the moral responsibility with the chairman of the committee.
Late
in the night it came to us. Late in the night. I left Delhi at 5 o'clock afternoon for Calcutta. Landing Calcutta, I had a message. I was repeatedly calling my residence. No report was received. Late in the night, I could not contact them for some time. Then around 10 o'clock, I had the information that it has been delivered to my house. I had asked the boy who works, how big is the report? He told me it is about more than 500 pages. The point is, such a voluminous report cannot be leaked. It has been handed over. Leakage is one thing. To give a part of it, a report of 500 pages cannot be leaked. It has been handed over. And it has been handed over well before the members got it. It has been politically done to say that the government of the day is innocent, NDA is to be blamed, everybody is to be blamed except the present government. It is shameful on the part of those who have drafted the report to attack a constitutional body in the way they have done. It is shameful for them to avoid Raja. There was earlier a joint parliamentary committee in 1991-92 on Harshad Mehta. When a leading congressman was the chairman, Mr. Mirtha, the main accused, Harshad Mehta, was called before the committee, and I still remember we sat late till morning around 4 o'clock. We questioned him. Therefore, two basic questions. Why this report had been given to the press? It is a deliberate move.
Sir, this is
because
a
Congress wants to take the wind out of the sail. That this is the JPC. It is not a JPC report. It is the report of some people.
Sir, this is a
who are blind to facts. Maybe it is done by some DOT people. I have an hunch. The report might have been some people might have handled it who work in DOT. For 2 months they drafted the report. For 2 months we did not have any meeting.
How would the DOT have the report before you, sir? How would the DOT have the report before you?
I am saying some people in DOT must have hand in drafting the report.
Sir, you are saying, sir, this is, you're making major allegations. You are saying that the two allegations,
absolutely,
both you and Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad are making the leakage into such a big issue. I'm surprised. Why are you both making the leakage into such a big issue? Whereas the contents of the report should be discussed. You are making a big deal about the leakage of the report. What is more important? Why are you going on about the leakage of the report? Mr. Prasad is also saying something here. Mr. Prasad, yes?
No. Please listen to me, gentlemen.
Arnav, can I come in here?
Arnav,
you are very right, Arnav.
But my
that the contents of the report
saying
is important.
My basic points
have
not
we have
saying
to say a lot about the contents of the report. And I have made that charge public. And I am again reiterating, it is not a JPC report. What has appeared in the media, it appears more like a Congress report designed to exonerate the Prime Minister and the Finance Minister. And shifting the blame to that Mr. Raja.
Sir, but you wasted. Sir, may I ask you? Sir, may I ask you, Mr. Prasad?
Please,
Mr. Prasad, you wasted one whole session of Parliament, winter of 2011. Winter of 2011, one whole session of Parliament you wasted because you wanted a JPC. Didn't you and Gurudas Dasgupta know the JPC representation will be based upon the number of parties, that you will be in a minority? Now you are calling it a Congress report?
Arnav, the question is, yes, Arnav, the question is not of minority or majority. There have been so many, we sit in the standing committee, I'm a member of the privilege committee, many other parliamentary committees, Gurdas Babu has been a member of JPC in the past, we have public accounts committee as well. There is certain parliamentary norms. When you sit in a committee, party affiliation is there in the parliament as well. But when you are examining a matter of great moment, namely the worst corruption case since independence, which shamed the entire country, there is certain obligation towards objectivity and fairness. And again, I wish to make it very clear. I have not gone through the report.
No, but why are you making the leakage of the report into a big issue? I am afraid, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. CAG report after CAG report has been put out on Times Now. You have never questioned why the CAG reports were leaked. Because at that point, the CAG report suited your argument. Today you make the leakage of the JPC report into a big issue.
One thing. No, not the least. Please give me some time. Allow me to make
my point.
I'm a member of JPC myself. And what Gurdas Babu also confirms, that none of us get a copy late in the night, early in the morning. We get up at 9:30 and suddenly the entire newspapers and the entire television media is full of the reports since yesterday.
Yeah.
Who is going to benefit out of it? That is the larger issue we are trying to highlight. Yes, I again repeat, we have very, very serious reservations about this report, which we shall articulate forcefully, firmly at the appropriate
forum, namely
the meeting of the JPC.
Yes, Mr. Dasgupta. Mr. Dasgupta.
My point is very simple. I do not call it a leakage. It is just handing over the report. Because the full newspapers are full with facts. I have not been able to read the report as yet. but I could know what is there in the report from you, as you say, from the other channels, and from the telephones that are coming to me every hour from Delhi. From them I understand what is there in the report. I am not making that a special point. My special point is Prime Minister. How this report could exonerate the Prime Minister? I have my full documents with me to show that Prime Minister was aware of all that was happening in the DOT. If we start telling him, first of all, a GOM was set up and the tarmac reference included pricing system. It was said that Minister of Finance and Minister of Telecommunication will jointly decide the price.